all, and today I am feeling super Christmassy because it's the 1st of December, which means we can open our advent calendar for the first time. So we are going to open drawer number one on our special advent calendar and we can see what's inside. So are we ready? Steady, go! Okay, we've got a piece of paper. Let's keep pulling it out. And it says, rocking around the Christmas tree game. So that's our treat for today. So here's our rocking around the Christmas tree board game that I have made. So you can see the start section at the bottom. And it's just like a board game where you will roll a dice and whatever number you get is how many places you can move around the Christmas tree. And the first person to get to the finish and they've rocked all the way around the Christmas tree is the winner. But because we're practicing our speech and our language when we're playing this game, whatever number we roll on the dice is the number of times we're going to do our practice before we move our counter. So if I rolled my dice and I got the number 4, I would do my target practicing 4 times, and once I've done my 4 practices, I can then move 4 spaces up. So this can be used if you're doing listening to sounds. So if you have your cards out and your adult who's practicing with you might say, am I saying b or f? And then they will say f, and you've got to point to the one that you think. So that would be one practice. So if you'd rolled a 4, you would do that 4 times, and then once you've done it, move your counters around the tree, and whoever rocks around all the way fastest and finishes first is our winner. But if you've not got a counter, then you can just use one from a different board game, or you could draw a picture and cut it out, or a piece of paper and use that to move around. And if you've not got a dice at home, that's fine too. You can just write the numbers 1 to 6 on pieces of paper, cut them out so they're all separate, pop them in a bag or a bowl, and then when it's your turn to pick a number, shut your eyes, dip your hand in the bowl, pick one out, and that's the number of times you can move around your board and do your practicing. So hopefully this is a fun game for you to use when you're practicing. And if you have not got a printer, then that's okay too. You could draw your very own board game like this. So draw a Christmas tree in the middle, lots of circles all the way around, and then you've got your very own board game too. Hope that helps, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow to open door number 2. Bye.